during that day, I mean, I was begging my husband to stay. I didn't want, you know, it's just, that was really raw. And it was me and my younger son. And I just kept saying, Alfie, please don't leave me. Please don't leave me. And then after I thought, why did you do that? He's sick. He's not well. He's in pain. Why are you asking him to stay? He has got to go. And, you know, and then I thought, yeah, and I can't be with him. That's right. You can't be with him. He's going to go alone. But it was, that was real, you know, that was just so hard because I never imagined my life. I kind of thought that he would probably die before me. He's 10 years older than I am, but not that, you know, not when he was, you know, 56, 57 years old. So it just was hard, you know, just a hard, hard thing, you know, and I really had a very difficult time after the funeral and though, you know, a few, maybe a week or so that afterwards. And that's when, you know, my kids were all a mess. And then one day I just finally said, well, hey, okay, that's enough, Pina. Your kids need you. You're the mother. You have to take care of them. They can't take care of you. So snap out of it and just get going. And I think that did help me, you know, to snap out of it and at least be able to deal, you know, with helping my children.